It's not the best on YouTube, but it is on YouTube. Being an entrepreneur is scary. Like a box of chocolates that is amorphously affected by ever-changing external rankings on a search engine, you never know what you're gonna get. There are moments of great success.
Great success!
And you also make some duds. We're a bunch of duds. And it can be a bit roller coastery, especially when your income is directly connected to the winds of entrepreneurial change. The trick is to keep making new stuff. Some of it is bound to stick. For me, it's around 1 in 8 projects, if that. Anyway, I'm super excited to showcase a new project today that seems to be establishing itself in the former category. Keep them fingers crossed. 8 megabyte video, online video compressor for Discord. Now, Discord seems like it has become almost overnight the most popular group chat community service. Originally popular with gamers, but now gone mainstream. But for anybody that's tried uploading a video to Discord, you've probably gotten the "your files are too powerful" error message. Unless you pay $10 a month, or a bunch of people have boosted the server, which also costs money, the upload limit is only 8 megabytes, about the size of a single smartphone photo. Forget 99% videos that have ever been made to have a chance to fit. But I like sharing memes and videos of my dog. And pasting a YouTube URL is only convenient when the content's already on YouTube. Sometimes you just have content you made yourself and want to send it on Discord, where the video's private and you don't want to upload it elsewhere. So I find myself just keeping Adobe Premiere open all the time just to import a new video, adjust the bitrate so the output fits 8 megabytes, and go from there. How stupid and annoying though. So I built an online video compressor service that does all of this automatically, as one does. The main draw of the site, it is super fast and easy to use. Works great both on desktop and on your phone. You can drag and drop files onto it, select files from your camera roll. You can even paste a link to a video online, like the one you're watching right now, for example. Do it. Just feed it a huge video and it'll spit out a smaller one. That's what it does, and it does it really well. I spent a ton of time optimizing it to balance encoding time and quality settings, and the default settings work out quite nicely. The optional options, should you opt to opt in to that kind of thing, let you turn on extra high quality mode at the expense of taking a longer time, mute the video or trim the video right within the interface, maybe cut out some lame intro or the VPN advertisement at the end of the video. It's a cool project too. Once you select your file, just click the upload button, which, by the way, turns into a random funny saying each time. So if you don't already have 8 megabyte video in your life, well, you need 8 megabyte video in your life. What do the compressed videos look like? It actually depends less on how big the source file is, like 100 megs or 500 megs, and more how long it is in seconds or minutes. As a general rule, anything that is 1 or 2 minutes will come out looking pretty good. 3 or 4 minutes tends to look all right, and beyond 5 minutes, the quality starts dropping off. It also depends on other factors like the nature of the source footage. Slow moving footage doesn't need a lot of bitrate, whereas lots of fast moving footage with constant 360 no scopes can push the limits. So the fun part right now is watching the growth of the service. Pretty much constant growth since launch, an average 38% growth month after month. As of the time of making this video, we're just about to hit a fun milestone of 5,000 unique users per day. Makes you wonder how much money Discord is not making because of the service. With 100,000 users a month, assuming that only 5% of them would have purchased Nitro but didn't, at $10 a month, that's $600,000 a year. I think you could buy one of those Peloton treadmills with that much cash. One cool thing I built to keep track of all this, I soldered one circuit board to another and wrote some ugly Python code, is my custom metrics display. And it's not just cool, it fulfills an important task. A Harvard MBA friend of mine once said, "You get what you inspect, not what you expect." And it couldn't be more true. Whether you're managing an employee, maintaining an HVAC system, or building an online service, you have to keep your eye on the primary goal. Otherwise, you may find yourself slipping into weird patterns of optimizing the wrong thing. And that's one of the worst things you can do as an engineer. It's basically throwing away time and money. The lesson is important. If you don't actively inspect things, they tend to wander from your expectations. Sometimes a little, sometimes a lot, sometimes slowly, and sometimes overnight. You have to keep an eye on it. You get what you inspect, not what you expect. So while art, the beauty of life, and love cannot be distilled to a certain number, business metrics often can. This display shows, on the top line from left to right, the number of unique users 8 MB videos had in the last 24 hours, updated once a minute, pulled from the Cloudflare API. Next is my number of YouTube subscribers, and the last is the number of customers I have on a third, unrelated project. All real-time stats, delayed by no more than 60 seconds. For example, when I get a new YouTube subscriber, the display will flash, make a sound, and notify me before I even get the supposedly real-time notification on my phone directly from YouTube. I like when these numbers go up. It gives me instant feedback on how changes to the site are being loved or hated by the users. Or if something is wrong, I'll notice right away. The next number I think I need to add to the display, my Patreon number. Wait, what? Yes, I recently started a Patreon to help support all the stuff I create. And I'm taking a unique approach I haven't seen done elsewhere yet. The goal is to help support both my software creation, projects like 8 MB video, and my YouTube channel. So now is a great time to thank my Patreon supporters so far. That's really awesome you took a chance supporting someone new with no prior supporters. So thank you Granite T. Rock and Zach Bernier and 7 others lurking in the shadows. If you want to help contribute, even just $1 a month goes a huge way towards helping me pay for services like 8 MB video, which is not making any money at the moment. I'd rather build quality software and not place ads and junk on it. And that's something I could continue to do with your support. I've never supported one of my projects like this before, but I want to give it a shot. If you support the project at the $3 a month level, you get extra features and abilities on the site, like the ability to include longer videos and bypass the bitrate warning screens for those extreme compressors out there. But supporters at any amount will get to participate in Patreon-only posts and surveys, plus get a special supporter role on the 8 MB video Discord. On that note, come join our Discord. It was originally somewhat of a support server for the project, but since it mostly just works perfectly all the time, it kind of turned into an 8 MB video fan club, where we talk a lot about video compression, FFmpeg, programming, and beams. We actually just hit 100 users today as I'm making this video, so come stop by and be number 101. That's it for now. There's also some really other exciting stuff happening in my life right now, but needs to be saved for another time. Can tell you involves video and outer space. All right, that's it for now and thank you. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up. If you didn't like it, please give it a thumbs down. That way I know what kind of videos to make in the future. Thanks, ciao. That's how people move off frame, right? I'm a normal person. I make normal videos.